Artemisia Gentileschi is the most celebrated female artist of the 17th century, and she's perhaps the best known today. I think Artemisia's exceptional in the sense that she took on those big historical and biblical subjects. She brings something very, very different to these subjects that every other artist in the 17th century was painting as well. Artemisia is an artist whose life story has somewhat overshadowed her art. It is well known that she was raped by the painter Agostino Tassi in 1611, when she was just 17. The story of her rape has in some way sort of defined the way art historians have talked about her for many, many years now. I would argue that there were other experiences in her life that also shaped her and shaped her art. Artemisia was born in Rome. Her mother died when she was 12, and she was brought up by her father, Orazio, who was an established painter in Rome. Her father, Orazio, trained Artemisia in his own workshop, along with her three brothers, but Artemisia was clearly the most talented of all his children. She herself was a mother and lost four of her five children, and all of these life experiences must surely have deeply affected her. After training in Rome, she moved to Florence, and in Florence, she really transformed herself and became an independent artist. She was the first woman to gain membership to the Artists' Academy there. She learned how to read and write in Florence. She moved in intellectual circles, and through these people, she also obtained commissions. When Artemisia returned to Rome in 1620, after a few years in Florence, she was extremely successful, her works were sought after, and we know from a letter written by her husband that her house is full of cardinals and princes wanting pictures from her. Artemisia spent more or less the last 25 years of her life in Naples, where she set up a very successful workshop. Whilst Artemisia worked in Naples, she also teamed up with local artists, so there are some paintings that are collaborations. The fact that Artemisia managed to set up a successful business in Naples is extraordinary, given that she wasn't employed by the court, she wasn't protected by a wealthy husband or a single patron. The National Gallery recently acquired a painting by Artemisia Gentileschi, which is the self-portrait of St. Catherine of Alexandria. This has gone some way in redressing the balance of paintings by female artists in our collection, but we didn't just buy this picture because it's by a woman. Artemisia had been on our wish list for a very long time. She's one of the most important followers of Caravaggio, and this picture just ticked a lot of boxes for us. So Artemisia is looking out from the picture. She's very tightly cropped in half length with very sort of dramatic lighting. The figure we're looking at is St. Catherine of Alexandria in Egypt, who was said to be of noble birth, which is why she's often shown with the crown. But the halo and then the martyr's palm that she holds so delicately to her chest point to the fact that she's a saint, she's a martyr. She was tortured and tied to spiked wheels. She was actually freed from those wheels by an angel. So what you see is the broken wheel of her torture that she's overcome. The firm but gentle way her hands sort of rest on the instrument of her torture, I think, is very powerful. And a sort of quiet resilience in this picture. And if you look carefully, she has a sort of little furrowed brow, this kind of determination. It's a picture that we felt could speak to people in many different ways. The National Gallery acquisition has made me get to know Artemisia, both as a woman but also as an artist, and I've really grown to love her. Artemisia still feels very relevant today because I think people really identify with her story. The force of her pictures is something that really stands out among her contemporaries. As she said in one of her letters, she said she had the spirit of Caesar and the soul of a woman. And I think that just encapsulates perfectly what Artemisia is all about.